Yo, yo, yo. Appreciate y'all for stopping through. This isn't something that's new, but, you know, I just like to check out stuff that I like to check out. So, hey, what's up, Jason? So, hybrid keys. This was one of the new instruments that came with Contact 6, Complete 12. And I was interested in it. It was this one and Ethereal Earth were the two, the main ones that I was interested in. But also the third one. I just like the simple interface and everything like that. So I'm just finally getting a chance to really kind of check it out. Figured I'd just go live and kind of go through some of the sounds just to see what they're working with. This one was probably the one I was most interested in, hybrid keys. Just wanted to kind of see what they did with that. So, yo, Ryra. Maxco, yo, what's up, what's up? So, yeah, man, we're just going to check it out. I got it loaded up in Complete Control. Let me know if that level was high enough for y'all. This is the seventh harps. Of course, you know, since it's, you know, NKS, Complete Control, you can just reach out and mess with it. But what I like about this instrument and the three new instruments is how simple it is. And the sounds seem to load really fast, so it kind of gives me that hardware feel where I can just go through sounds really quickly. And of course, it's Native Instruments, so it sounds good. But one thing for me, in my workflow, when I'm making music, and one of the reasons I like to go with hardware is just the ease of use and how quick it is to get to my sounds. I don't have to do a bunch of different clicking and stuff like that. So with something like this, being inside a Complete Control, it kind of gives me that workflow and I can just route it to my hardware and treat it like it's just another synth or something. So I like that. So let's see. And of course you got the previews, so you can just quickly. And I like this little blend knob, so you can quickly go between sounds. And of course you can go in here and kind of pull up the browser and change the different layers and mix and match stuff. So I think it sounds pretty good. And I personally like the fact that it's really simple, because it just makes it easier to get to the sounds. And as you guys can see, the sounds load really fast. That's a huge one for me as well. Yo, what's up, Mr. Keys? Appreciate it. And of course, being inside of Complete Control, or just being NKS, you can use all the scale and chord and stuff like that. But yeah, right now I'm just going through some of these sounds. And one of the main reasons I was interested in this one is I really like organic sounds. I mean, I like synths, but 9 times out of 10, the synth sounds that I choose are really basic. And I tend to go more towards traditional instruments and acoustic sounds and stuff like that. So I love playing with synths, but when it comes to making music and making tracks and different stuff like that, I really like the organic sound. So I feel like this kind of gives you that vibe, but it's still a little bit different. Anytime I get a sound that makes me just want to try to play something, I feel like it's good. And that, for me, that's where, you know, the inspiration comes from. And I also like how they kind of describe this. So you got warm place, dark place. You know what I'm saying? Like, so there's just a pad by itself. So I really like how you can blend it. Yeah, that's pretty cool, man. So, of course, you can go through. Yeah, it does. It's really got a warm, kind of a smooth, organic vibe to it. Like I said, I haven't gone through all the sounds. I'm just kind of going through picking some stuff. So maybe there's some things that sound different. But I'm liking what I'm hearing so far. Like I said, I know this isn't new. But for me, it's kind of new in the workflow, even though, you know, I've had it since Complete 12 came out. I just really haven't had had time to really mess with it. I think they did a good job on this. I really, really dig this, the vibe of it. Like, that's dope. And if y'all notice me, I really like kind of that mid to lower mid area. Like, the highs can be cool. Like, you can get some cool stuff in there. But even, like, when I'm playing, like, my Rhodes or something like that, I usually go for the mid to low mid section. I just like that. I like that tone right there. How you can blend it, man. Like I said, it's super simple, but it sounds good. I wish they put something like this in a box, man. It could be something the size of their little 25 key joint. Just throw some of these types of instruments in there. I'd be happy. That way I could just turn it on and go. That's dope. So let's see. Brass. Oh, that's actually the one I was playing. Bet. It's Got some mallet instruments. Let's check out some of these. Yeah, this joint is yeah, definitely that soundscape. Hey, Bueno from Jamaica, what's up, what's up? I like the variety, because, like, you know, you get those nice smooth tones, and then now you get these mallet kind of plucky sounds, but it still has that organic vibe. Change the reverb. But I'm still a fan of how they just, the whole NKS situation where you can just quickly tweak a sound is dope to me also. Let's see. Anybody out here using Complete 12 or using any of these instruments in their production and their workflow? I know it's been out for a minute. Oh, come on, man. Ty. Don't be that guy. Sounds pretty cool. Let's see. And if any of you have been around the channel or the website for a while, you know I really dig like a music box, Glockenspiel, those types of things. So this right here, I love sounds like that. Yo, J Beats, what's up? And even though they're hybrid, you know, with a little mixture of acoustic and synthetic sounds in there. It's a real organic feel. I dig it. Just checking out these sounds. Let's see. It's like you got some different organs. Bad. And I like that they're just a little bit more on the almost kind of there's a roundness and a smoothness to the overall instrument. Even if I turn up the crunch, it's still smooth. I dig that. So yeah, man. Definitely digging this. I think I checked out some of these already. Let's see. Yeah, I like this a lot, actually. I feel like, you know, I know, you know, Native makes a lot of different instruments. A lot of it can be synth heavy and stuff like that. But, you know, then they do like the orchestral stuff and the pianos and all that different stuff. But what I like about these, this instrument at least, and the other ones, I haven't really dug into the other ones yet. But just if they're like this, it's so simple and it doesn't take up a lot of space. It doesn't take up a lot of time to load. That's huge for me. Take out the lo-fi if you want. Make it sound more traditional. Yeah, I dig it. Man, yo, this is I think they did their thing on this one. There's definitely a variety, so you can go just straight up beat making, you can go scoring, you can go video game, but it all still has that smooth organic vibe to it from what I'm hearing. Cool. Let's see. I think we did. Yeah, we did that. It looks like there's a couple synth leads, actually. And that's with the tape drive. Pretty cool. Let's see. Yeah, man, this is cool. And like I said, you can just go in if you want to just make up your own stuff and just go through the sounds. You can see all the different sources and stuff they got. I don't know, man. I don't know what took me so long. I'm kind of upset. Honestly, I really haven't been messing with a lot of software instruments for a minute. Just really been kind of messing with a bunch of hardware stuff, you know. But I knew I was interested in this when it said hybrid keys. I was like, man, that sounds like something I'd be interested in. Like I said, Incomplete 12, probably this, and Ethereal Earth, I think that's what it's called. It's another one like this. And even the Analog Dreams or something. Like the three new joints that they did for Contact that looked like this really had me interested. Like those were probably the things I was interested the most inside of Complete 12, honestly. I just haven't had really had time to mess with them. I've just been messing with a lot of other stuff. And like I said, a lot of times when I'm using software, it's usually an iPad app. So I just haven't really messed with it. But I'm, yo, this joint is definitely going to be part of the rotation, man. Because I'm digging it. And of course, I got to check out some of these pads. No, I just, for me, it's just it's really a workflow thing, but I can definitely, with this, I can definitely fit it into how I like to work, because like I said, I can just pull it up in complete control or machine and just run it into whatever I'm recording into, so. And I like the fact that the sounds load super, super quick. Of course, I could browse from the controller if I want to as well, so. Like, there's no load time. It just loads. Like, for me, that's also an issue with, like, you know, there's some awesome contact libraries and a lot of these, you know, libraries that even, you know, Native puts out and stuff like that, like, super dope. But it's like, when I'm working and I got to wait for something to load, even if it's just a little bit, I'll just be like, ah, man, I'd rather not. So, for example, like, you know, they have... those orchestral, I can't think of the name, the orchestral series things that they have. You know, they have a full version, and then they have a light version or an element version or something like that, a smaller version. And they both come with inside of Complete 12, but I installed the smaller version just because they load faster. Even though I know there's more stuff in the bigger ones, I want to be able to just quickly load up sounds, man. The Windows laptops and Iron GPUs. Man, I would just say look for something that matches the specs of what Complete 12 says is required. I think as long as you get something like an i7, you know, a quad core, you got about, I would say 8 is the minimum gigabytes of RAM I would suggest, but I would probably try to go 16 if you can. And then if you can get something that has a solid state drive, I think you'll be fine with Complete 12 Collector's Edition. Yeah, that joint's huge, though, so that will be a big solid state drive. But, man, I'm telling you, like, loading it from an SSD is definitely going to change a lot. And, you know, Contact has some things built in that makes it pretty cool as far as background loading and stuff like that. But the GPU itself won't make a huge difference as far as when it comes to complete and stuff like that. But if you're doing videos and stuff like that, like for me, the GPU inside of a laptop or, you know, a desktop is super important as well. So if you can get something that has 4 to 8 gigs of RAM dedicated to on the GPU itself, that's dope as well. Yeah, I've heard good things about the Ryzen. Yeah, I mean, I would say 8 gig minimum just for RAM in general. But, I'm a proponent of if you can go higher, especially when you're using heavy sample-based instruments, if you can do 16 and it's not a huge jump and it's in your budget, I would definitely try to do that. I'll just say the most RAM you can get for your budget, that's what I would do, definitely, you know, in relation to everything else as well. Like, make sure you get a nice hard drive, make sure you got a nice processor and stuff like that. But definitely, when you're using something like, you know, string libraries and horn libraries and, you know, all these sample-based libraries, it's definitely good to have that memory, definitely, if you can. But, yeah, a lot of the laptops that are coming out now, man, should be fine. So, yeah, guys, I appreciate y'all stopping through, man. Hybrid Keys, if you haven't checked this joint out inside of Complete 12, definitely check it out. Now, I'm not sure if you own a previous version of Contact, like Contact 4 or 5, and you update to Contact 6, I think... I think you get these instruments. I think these come with Kontakt 6. So you don't have to get Complete just to get these. Like, you can just upgrade your version of Kontakt if you wanted to just do that. So, you know, there's multiple ways of doing it. But this is really cool, man. Definitely glad I took some time to check it out. It's definitely going to be one that goes into my workflow. I like how fast it loads. I'll probably check out one of the other ones next in the coming weeks. Probably Ethereal Earth or Analog Dreams, one of the two. Probably Ethereal Earth first, because that's the other one I was really interested in for my style. But I'll probably end up checking them all out. So, yeah, man, appreciate y'all stopping through. Yeah, I agree, desktops, because you can upgrade. Definitely, definitely. But, you know, if you got to be mobile, there's definitely some dope laptops out there. So, yeah, appreciate y'all stopping through. Come through and stop by the shop. If you look for some presets, plugins, and things like that, I definitely appreciate that. Either way, like, comment, subscribe. And yeah, man, I'll see y'all later. Let me know if you're interested in some of these other instruments you want me to check out. Like I said, I'll probably check out the other Play Series stuff, Ethereal Earth in the future, and probably Analog Dreams. That'll probably be the last one. It'd be cool to see if they come out with some other ones, man. I don't know. It'd be cool to see. I like this style and format of instrument. The huge stuff is cool with all the, you know, extra huge libraries and stuff like that. That's cool. But yeah, yo, J-Rock, what up, bro? What up, what up? Yeah, all that stuff is cool. But for me, when I'm working, I just like stuff that's obviously it has to sound good, but I like that I can just go through and load sounds really quick. And this really loads pretty fast. I dig it. So yeah, man, appreciate y'all stopping through. Hope y'all enjoy the rest of y'all's day, and I'll see y'all later. Peace.